don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Whoa! Did you see that? I think that friend was feeling angry. Hi friends, I'm Miss Robin, and today we're going to talk about a big, powerful feeling, and that feeling is angry. You might feel angry sometimes, and that's okay. Did you know that angry feelings can happen very quickly? They can. Just like when you see lightning in the sky, it flashes very quickly, and then all of a sudden, you hear thunder. Anger can happen that fast in your body. When something upsets you, you might feel a big burst of angry feelings inside of your body. That angry energy wants to come outside of your body. So you might do things like, stomp your feet, or you might say words like, no, or you might even fold your arms quickly and say things like, That can happen when you're angry. That is the angry energy wanting to get outside of your body. When you feel angry, your face can look like this friend's face. Did you know that different types of things can happen to upset you and make you feel angry? Yeah, they can. Why do you think these friends are feeling angry? Yes, you're right. They both want the toy. They don't want to share. But you know what they can do? They can use their words and they can say, I'm angry. But can we share? Now, why do you think this friend is angry? Yes, you're right again. Mommy or Daddy said, no, you can't have it right now. You have to wait until later. Sometimes waiting can feel so frustrating and we start to feel angry. But you know what we can say? We can say, I'm angry, but can we talk about it, Mommy? Now, why do you think this friend is angry? Yes, they're angry because they wanted to put their socks on by themselves, but they couldn't figure out how to do it. They needed help. That friend can say, I'm angry, but I can ask for help. Did you know that your angry feelings will go away? They can. When you're feeling angry, you can calm your body by taking deep breaths and relaxing. If you're feeling angry, you can move your body away from the person that's making you feel upset. You can get space. If you're feeling angry, you can talk to a friend or a grown-up and talk about things so that you understand what happened. And then you'll start to feel better. Yeah, those angry feelings will go away. Well, friends, you did a great job today. We learned about angry feelings and how to make angry feelings go away. We learned how feelings feel inside of your body and what we can do to feel better again. Well, friends, keep learning and growing. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Hello, my stars. Here's the word. Please. Let's spell it. P-L-E-A-S-E. Please. Let's sound it out. P-lease. 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 up. Please, please, please. This is how you sign please. You take your hand and you put it on your chest and you rub, rub, rub. Please, please, please. Can I please have more water, please? More water, please. Please. Yes, please. You're so smart. Let's keep going. Hey, little stars. We get to learn how to make our ABCs using a red marker. Let's get started. The first letter we're going to make is the letter A. So we're going to make a capital A. We're going to go up the hill and down the hill and across. Now we're going to make a lowercase a. So we're going to make a circle and a line. Uppercase a and lowercase a. Now we're going to use our eraser to erase it. Boop, boop, boop. Let's do our next letter. The next letter we're going to do is the letter B. So we're going to go down and make a little bubble and a big bubble. Now we're going to make a lowercase b. So we're going to go down and make a little bubble. Uppercase, lowercase. The next letter we're going to make is the letter C. So we're going to go down and around. There's our uppercase C. Now we're going to make our lowercase c. Down and around. Uppercase C, lowercase c. Okay, let's erase it and do our next letter. Our next letter is the letter D. So we're going to make a line going down and make a big bubble. Now we're going to make lowercase d. So we're going to make a line and a little bubble. Uppercase D, lowercase d. Let's erase it and do our next letter. The next letter we get to do is the letter E. So we're going to go down and make three lines. One, two, three. Now we're gonna make a lowercase e. So we're gonna make a little line and go up and over. Uppercase e, lowercase e. Now let's do our next letter. The next letter we get to do is the letter F. So we're gonna make a line coming down, and a line at the top, and a line in the middle. And now we're gonna make lowercase f. So we're going to make a candy cane that goes down and a line in the middle of the candy cane. Uppercase F, lowercase F. Let's erase it and do our next letter. Are you having so much fun doing this? Me too. Let's keep going. We're going to make the letter G. So we're going to go around and up and in. And now we're going to make a lowercase g. Make a circle and an upside down candy cane. Uppercase G and lowercase G. Now let's erase it and do our next letter. The next letter that we get to do is the letter H. So we're going to go down and down and a line in the middle. Uppercase H. Now we get to make our lowercase h. Down and a little arch. Uppercase H, lowercase h. This is so much fun. Now let's erase it to make our next letter. The next letter we're going to do is the letter I. So we're going to make a line coming down, and we're going to make a line at the top and at the bottom. Uppercase I. The next letter we're going to make is lowercase I. So we make a tiny little line and a dot on the top. Uppercase I, lowercase I. Okay, let's erase it and make our next letter. The next letter we get to do is the letter J. So we're going to make an upside down candy cane and a line on top. And now we get to make our lowercase j. Another upside down candy cane and a dot on top. Uppercase J, lowercase j. Now let's erase it into our next letter. The next letter we get to make is the letter K. So we're going to make a big line coming down and two big lines coming out of the big line. uppercase K. Now we get to make lowercase K. So we're going to make a little line down and two little lines coming out. One, two. Uppercase K, lowercase K. I'm having so much fun doing this. Let's erase it and do our next letter. The next letter we get to do is the letter L. So we're going to make a line coming down and we're going to go over. Uppercase L. Now we get to make lowercase L. Just a line coming down. Uppercase L, lowercase L. Now let's erase it and make the next one. The next letter that we get to do is the letter M. So we're going to go up the mountain, down the mountain a little bit, back up the mountain, and back down the mountain. Now we're going to make lowercase M. We're going to go down the mountain, and up, and over, and up, and down. Uppercase M, lowercase M. You're doing so good learning how to write your ABCs. Let's do the next letter together. The next letter that we get to do is the letter N. So we are going to go up the mountain, down the mountain, and back up. There's our uppercase N. Now we're going to do our lowercase N. Down the mountain and over. Uppercase N and lowercase N. Our next letter we get to do is the letter O. So we're going to make a big circle. Uppercase O, and we're going to make a little circle for lowercase O. And a little circle. It's like a mommy circle and a baby circle. The next letter we get to do is the letter P. So we're going to go down and make a little bubble at the top. Uppercase P. Now we get to make our lowercase P. We're going to make another line that goes down and another little bubble. Uppercase P, lowercase P. Let's do our next letter. The next letter we get to do is the letter Q. So we're going to make a big circle and a line that comes out of it. Uppercase Q. Now we get to make lowercase Q. So we're going to make a little circle and a line that goes down and up. Uppercase Q, lowercase Q. Okay, let's do our next letter. The next letter we get to do is the letter R. So we're going to go down the mountain and a bubble and a line that comes right out of the bubble. Uppercase R. Now we're going to make lowercase R. We're going to go down a little mountain and go halfway across. Uppercase R, lowercase R. This is so much fun. Let's keep going. The next letter that we get to do is the letter S. So we get to start at the top of the mountain and go up and down and around. Uppercase S. And now we get to make lowercase S. We're going to go on a little mountain and go up and down and around. Uppercase S, lowercase S. All right, let's keep going. The next letter we get to do is the letter T. So we're going to go down the mountain and make a line on top. Uppercase T. Now we get to make lowercase T. So we're going to make another line that goes down and a little line that goes in the middle. Uppercase T, lowercase T. All right, let's keep going. The next letter that we get to do is the letter U. So we're going to start at the top of the mountain and go down, and then we're going to go back up. Boop. Uppercase U. Now we're going to make lowercase U. So we're going to go down a little mountain and back up the little mountain and make a line. Uppercase U and lowercase U. I'm having so much fun writing the letters with you. Let's do our next letter. Now we get to make the letter V. So we're going to go down the mountain and right back up. Now we get to make lowercase V. Down a little mountain and right back up. Uppercase V and lowercase V. Okay, let's erase it and do our next one. The next letter that we get to do is the letter W. So we are going to go down the mountain and up a little bit, back down the mountain, and all the way back up. Now we get to make a lowercase W. We're going to go down a little mountain, go back up the mountain a little bit, go back down, and back up. uppercase W, lowercase W. The next letter that we get to do is the letter X. So we're gonna go down this way and down this way. There's our uppercase X. Now we're gonna make our lowercase X. We're gonna go down this way and down that way. Uppercase X and lowercase X. All right, let's keep going. We're doing really good. The next letter that we get to make is the letter Y. So we're gonna go down the mountain a little bit and back up and put a line at the bottom. Uppercase Y. Now we're gonna make lowercase Y. So we're gonna go down the mountain a little bit and then we're gonna go way down the mountain. Uppercase Y and lowercase Y. Okay, now we get to do our last letter. So let's erase our letter Y. The last letter that we get to make together is the letter Z. So we're gonna start up here and go zig, zag, zig. There is our uppercase Z. Now we get to make our lowercase Z. A little zig, zag, Z. Uppercase Z and lowercase Z. Oh my gosh, I had such a fun time making the ABCs with you. I loved it so much, I'm gonna make a heart. Just for you. All right, I'll see you next time. Bye.
So pretty and bright, all together with the lovely sunshine. Makes me so happy the way that it shines. I love the rainbow, don't you?
ABCs. Are you so excited? I am. Let's get started. We're going to sign the first letter, which is A. So you put your hand up and you make a fist. This is the letter A. Now let's try it together. Put your hand up and close it. This is the letter A. Good job. Let's move on to the next letter. You're gonna put your hand up, put your thumb across like this. This is the letter B.
B. B.
Let's try that together. Put your hand up, put your thumb across, B. Good job. Now we're gonna do the letter C. Put your hand up and you make the C with your hand. Do you see it? The letter C.
C. C.
Let's do it together. Hand up and like this. C. Next, we're gonna sign the letter D. So put your hand up and point to the sky like this. D.
D.
Now let's try it together. Put your hand up and point to the sky. Hey, that's really good. Now we're gonna learn the letter E. So put your hand up and you close your hand like this. E. You wanna make sure you can see all of your knuckles. E.
E. E.
Now let's try this one together. It's a little tricky. Put your hand up and close it. Make sure you can see all of your knuckles. This is the letter E. Now we're gonna do the letter F. This one's really fun. So you put your hand up and you just put your finger to your thumb. F.
F. F.
Can you show me how you sign the letter F? Hey, that's awesome! F. Next, we're gonna learn to sign the letter G. So put your hand up and we're gonna go like this. You're gonna make your pointer finger and your thumb almost touched, but not quite yet. This is the letter G.
G. G.
Let's do it again. Put your hand up and pinch your fingers close together. G. The next letter that we get to sign is the letter H. So what you're gonna do is put your hand up and point two fingers to the side. H.
H. H.
Let's do it again together. Put your hand up and point two fingers to the side. H. That was really good. We get to learn how to sign the letter I. So let's put our hand up, make a fist, and point our pinky finger up to the sky, like this.
I. I.
Now let's try it again together. Put your hand up, make a fist, and put your pinky up to the sky, just like this. Letter I. All right. Now we get to learn how to sign the letter J. So we're gonna put our hand up, make a fist, point your pinky up, and then scoop like that.
J. J.
Now let's do it again, because this one's a little tricky. Put your hand up, make a fist, put your pinky up, and scoop. J. That was a good job. Let's sign the letter K. So put your hand up, make a fist, and put two fingers up. One, two, and you're gonna put your thumb right in between your two fingers. K.
K. K.
Let's do it again. Put your hand up, make a fist, put two fingers up, and put your thumb right in between. Hey. All right, now let's do the letter L. So you're gonna put your hand up, make a fist, and point your finger up and your thumb out. L.
L. L.
Let's do it together. Hand up, make a fist, one finger up, and your thumb to the side. L. That was really good. Let's keep going. Next, we're gonna learn how to make the letter M. So put your hand up, and we're gonna count three spaces with our thumb. One, two, three. We're gonna close our hand. Do you see my little thumb hiding in there? M.
M. M.
Now let's try this one again together. It's a little tricky. Put your hand up, count three spaces. One, two, three, and put it right in M. Next, we get to learn the letter N. It's a lot like the letter M. So let's try it. Put your hand up and count two spaces. One, two. Put your fingers down. Do you see my thumb hiding? There's the letter N.
N. N.
Let's do it again. Put your hand up. Count two spaces with your thumb. One, two. put it down. N. The next letter we get to learn is O. This one's really easy. Just put your hand up and make an O, just like that. I see you. O.
O. O.
Can you show me how you make an O? Good job! All right, next we're gonna learn how to sign the letter P. So put your hand up and pretend that you're doing the letter K. So put your fingers like this, but instead we're gonna go down. P.
P. P.
Let's do it again. Put your hand up, put your thumb in between your two fingers, and go down. P. The next letter we're gonna learn is the letter Q. So put your hand up, squish your fingers together like this, and point them down. Q.
Q. Q.
Let's do it again. Put your hand up, squish your fingers together, and point down. Q. Now we're gonna learn how to sign the letter R. Put your hand up, and you're gonna twist your two fingers like this. R.
R. R.
Now let's do it again. Put your hand up and twist your two fingers. R. Good job. Now we get to learn the letter S. You put your hand up, you make a fist, and you put your thumb in front. S.
S. S.
Let's try it again. Hand up, make a fist, put your thumb in front. S. Now we're gonna learn how to make the letter T. Put your hand up and count one space with your thumb. One, and close. Do you see my thumb in there? T.
T.
Now let's try it again. Put your hand up, count one space, and put your fingers down. T. Next, we're gonna learn how to sign the letter U. So put your hand up and put two fingers up to the sky and keep them really close together. This is the letter U.
U. U.
Let's try it again. Put your hand up and point two fingers to the sky. Letter U. Now we're gonna learn the letter V. The letter V is a lot like the letter U. So what you're gonna do is put your hand up, point two fingers to the sky, and separate them. V.
V. V.
Let's do it again together. Put your hand up, point two fingers to the sky, and separate them. V. We get to make the letter W. So what we're gonna do is put our fingers up and count three. One, two, three. Our other fingers are gonna go down. Now we get to spread our fingers like this. It makes a W.
W.
W. Now let's try it again. Put your hand up. Count three fingers. One, two, three. And spread them. W. Next, we get to make the letter X. So what we're gonna do is put our hand up and we're gonna hug our thumb with these three fingers. And this little finger's gonna curl. X.
X. X.
Now let's do it one more time. We're gonna put our hand up and our fingers are gonna hug our thumb, and then we'll curl our finger, X. Now we get to make the letter Y. So what we're gonna do is put our hands up, make a fist, and our thumb and our pinky are gonna go out, like this, Y.
Y. Y.
Let's do it again together. Put your hand up, make a fist, and have your thumb and your pinky go out. Why? Now we get to make the last letter of the alphabet, the letter Z. So what we're gonna do is have our hand up, point one finger to the sky, and make a zigzag like a Z. Z.
Z. Z.
Let's do it again. Put your hand up, point one finger to the sky, and make a Z. I had such a fun time learning how to sign the ABCs with you. I can't wait to sign with you again. I'll see you soon. Bye.
Hi friends. My name is Miss Robin Reads a Lot. And today we're going to talk about something very special. It's a big feeling. And that feeling is called love. Mama and Dada love you. Mama loves you. She says, I 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 love you. Dada loves you. He 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 says, I love you. Remember, friends, love is a big and important feeling, the most special feeling of all. And Mama and Dada love you. Bye-bye.
farmer had a dog and Bingo was his name. Oh, B-I-N-G-O, 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 and Bingo was his name. Oh.
A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
Hi everyone, I'm Miss Robin. I'm so excited to share a special feeling with you today, and that feeling is happy. Friends, being happy feels so good. Do you feel happy? When you're happy, you'll have a smile on your face. Let's watch this friend. When you're happy, you'll feel like you have a smile in your heart. Let's watch this friend. When you're happy, you might hear a sound coming out of your mouth that sounds like this. Yeah. Let's watch this friend. How do you think this friend feels? Yes, you guessed it. They feel happy. How do you think they feel? Right again. They feel happy. How do you think this person feels? Right again, you're so good at this. They feel happy too. Very good, friends, very good. Well, friends, you did a great job. You're so smart. Well, I hope that you'll remember that feeling happy is a great feeling, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.
Itsy bitsy spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider went up the spout again. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider went up the spout again.
Spider, go, 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 spider, go, go, go. Lesai's Big Adventures.
Let's go to the fair.
We're going to the fair today. There are so many things to see at the fair. People are riding the rides. Some are riding swings way up high. Others are going around and around. Look at them go. Some are going around and up and down. Whoa! That looks like so much fun. Look at these people way up by the top of the trees. There are lots of food and treats at the fair. I had a churro. It was so tasty. We saw toy animals and real animals. And I rode the piggy train. We went to see the cows. They're really big, so we couldn't get too close. But then, we went to the petting zoo, and we fed the goats. They're so nice. It was time to wash our hands. I played on a tractor. And we watched monster trucks race around the track. Look at that truck go! Wow! Oh no! Oh, great! They're okay! The trucks were so loud! Watching the trucks was so much fun! Now it's my turn to drive a truck. Vroom. We went around and around and around again. Then it was time to do some climbing. Looks like I'm going to make it. Well, it's time to go. What a great day. And now it's time for a break. Bye for now.
This is my mystery bag. Oh my goodness, it's pretty heavy. Listen to when I shake it. Do you hear that? It's making some really cool sounds. Let's see what's in there. it's blue. Let's see what else is in here. And a ball. That's so fun. Oh, what? Oh, it sticks together. Whoa, that's so cool. Oh my goodness. Let's see. I think I can add some more pieces on here. One. Two. Three. Four. It looks like a flower. Oh, it's so pretty. I like all the colors we used. We used three yellow pieces. One, two, three. And one pink piece. One pink and one blue piece too. Oh, that's so cool. I wonder if we could spin it. Whoa, it spins. Oh, that's so cool. Back in the basket. I wonder what else we should make with these really cool toys. Oh, I have an idea. Let's try it. So first, I'm gonna take a circle. I'm gonna get two red pieces and put them right here. One, two, look at how they stick on there. And now I'm gonna add another ball at the bottom. One right here, and one right here. Now I'm gonna take this blue piece and put it right here. Whoa, hey, we made a shape. Do you know what shape this is? It's a triangle. Oh, it's so cool. Let's see what else we can add on to our triangle. I know. We can add this orange piece right here. And let's add another orange piece. Oh, and two more balls. One and two. Now I'm gonna take a big purple piece and put it right in the middle. Hey! This looks like a house. That's so cool. We have two red pieces, one, two, one blue piece, two orange pieces, one, two, and one purple piece. Whoa, that was so loud. Let's see what else we could make. Ooh, I really like the color orange, so I'm gonna use this orange piece, and I'm gonna take a ball and put it right here. And another ball and put it right at the bottom. Look how fun that is. It looks like a weight, like lifting weights. Oh, we're so strong. Woohoo! Lift weights. Let's see what else we can add to this. Ooh, I know. We can put this blue piece right here. And another ball at the end of it. Oh. It looks like a letter. Do you know what letter this looks like? A V, that's right! V. Oh, I know. We can add one more piece to turn it into another letter. What letter does this look like? The letter Y! Oh, that's so cool. I wonder what happens if we turn it upside down. Whoa, that's so cool. We can spin it around and around. Oh. Into the bag. I wonder what else we could make. I think I'm gonna use the color red. Red with a little white ball on top. Maybe if we connect this curved piece right here and get another ball out and connect those pieces together and maybe one more red piece. Hey, this looks like a letter, but it's upside down. Let's see. It's the letter U. That's so fun. Turn it back this way. Now I'm gonna add another big red piece right here. And one more ball. Hey, it kind of looks like a giraffe. It's a giraffe in the jungle. Look at its long neck. That's so cool. Let's add a mouth for our giraffe here. There we go. Now it really looks like a giraffe. Should we break it? Okay, here we go. Back in the bag. What else can we make? I have an idea. We can try to make a heart. We'll use this purple piece with this purple piece. Does this look like a heart? No, not yet. We need a few more pieces. one ball right here and one ball right here. Does this look like a heart? No, not yet. We just need a few more pieces. One right here and another piece right here. Does this look like a heart? Almost. It looks like it's missing something. Maybe if we add one more ball right in the middle here. Let's see if I can. Connect these pieces. One, two. There we go! Does this look like a heart? Yes, it does! We made a heart with two purple pieces, one red piece, and one blue piece. It's so fun! Should we break the heart? Oh, back in the bag. Hey, I have an idea. Let's make a rocket ship, okay? Let's use the color red. Here we go. We have a piece of our rocket ship ready to go. Now let's use orange. One right here. We need a ball to connect the bottom of the rocket ship. Here we go. Put a yellow piece right here. And another yellow piece. Look at the rocket ship. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off! Oh, there it goes! Back down to Earth. Oh my gosh, that was so much fun. Let's see if we can spin our rocket ship. Whoa! Look at it spin! Round and around. Uh-oh, I made a mess! I have to clean that up. I'll be right back. I wonder how many pieces we can attach to just one ball. Let's count together, okay? All right. One, two, three, four, five. Oh my gosh, that's so many. Six, seven, whoa. Eight, nine, let's see if we can fit one more, and 10. Whoa, that's so cool. Now let's see if I can hold on to it just by using this one. It worked. Let's see if we can spin it. Whoa, that is so cool. Spin it like this too. Round and around and around and around. Uh-oh, I dropped it. That's okay. Now we can make something new. Hey, I have an idea. I think I'm gonna make a hat. Can you help me make a hat? Awesome. First we need to start with a triangle. Oh, here we go. Just gotta add a ball on top. Here's our triangle. This will be the bottom of the hat. We'll add some more pieces. Red, blue, and purple. And now we just need a ball to connect them at the top. There we go. Okay, here's the hat. Let's put it on. Da-da-da-da! Woo! I made a hat! Uh-oh, I feel a sneeze coming on. Uh-oh, I broke the hat! Oh well, I'll just make it again. Whoa, I have a really good idea, but it's gonna take almost all the pieces in our mystery bag to make it. We are going to make a crane. Do you think you can help? Awesome, let's get started. I'm gonna move my mystery bag to the side so we have more space. Okay, let's get started. First, we're gonna make a square. Now we need a few more little pieces. We'll use yellow and blue and orange and red. And we're gonna connect them all with one ball. Whoa, it's already starting to get so big. Now that we made the bottom of the crane, we can make the top of the crane. So let's move this piece over here just a little bit. I'm gonna get another red piece and put it right here. And another ball. And we'll connect it right here. It doesn't quite look like a crane just yet. It needs just one more piece. Oh, I know. I can use the other red piece that curves. There we go. We have our crane. But it needs something to pick up. Oh, maybe we could use another ball and it can pick it up. What do you think? Awesome. Let's try. The ball right here. And let's see if we can get the crane to pick it up. Here comes the crane. It worked! It picked up the ball. Okay, crane, put it in the mystery bag. In the bag. Oh, that's so cool. I really like our crane that we made together. Wow, I had such a fun time using our imagination to build things with you. Okay, crane, back into the mystery bag you go. And I can't wait to make more with you soon. Bye.
Hi, friends. I'm Miss Robin. And today we're going to learn about a really big feeling. And that feeling is sad. Being sad does not feel good, but it's okay to feel sad. Have you ever felt sad? When you're sad, sometimes tears fall from your eyes and you cry. Have you ever cried? Me too. When you're sad, your body feels like a big balloon. When all the air rushes out. When you feel sad, you might hear this sound coming from your mouth. Lots of things can make you feel sad. Why do you think this friend is sad? Yes, she wants to play with mommy, but mommy has to go away. She can say, I'm sad. Why do you think this friend is sad? Yes, you're right. She can't find her favorite toy. She can say, I'm sad. Now, why do you think this friend is sad? Yes, you're right again. She fell down and hurt her knee. Ouch! She can say, I'm sad. Did you know that sad feelings can go away? They do, and you can feel better again. You did a great job today. Remember, it's okay to feel sad. Just know that you will feel better. Keep learning and growing. Bye-bye.
Juice. K. 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 turtle. U. Umbrella. Umbrella. B. Violin. Violin. W. Water. Water. X. X-ray. X-ray. Y. Yellow. Yellow. Z. Zebra. Zebra. I'll see you soon. Well, howdy there, little stars. We're gonna learn about farm animals today. I'm so excited. Oh, did you hear that? I think I heard something coming from the farmhouse. Let's knock on the door. Knock, knock, knock. Who's in there? What is that? It's a pig. It's so cute. Let's spell pig. P-I-G. Now let's make the same sound that we heard. Pigs go oink. Can you say oink, oink, oink with me? Oink, oink, oink. Oh my goodness. Hey, let's pretend that we're pigs. Put your hands up like this and make little piggy ears. Oink, oink, oink.
This is a pig. And these are baby pigs, also known as piglets. Did you know that they are some of the most intelligent animals on the planet? They have great memory, and despite playing in the mud all the time, they are some of the cleanest too. Pigs love belly rubs, and they love to eat. Are you going to go eat, Mr. Pig? Okay, take care. Bye.
Pigs are so cute, but they also really like to get dirty and play in the mud. Oh, hey, did you hear that? I think the farmhouse is making more sounds. There it is again. Let's knock on the door. Knock, knock, knock. Open the door. What's inside? Oh my goodness. It's a cow. Let's spell cow. C-O-W. Let's make the sounds that a cow makes. Cows say moo. Can you say moo with me? One, two, three, moo. Hey, that was pretty good. Let's pretend that we're cows. This cow has horns. Can you make horns on your head like this and go moo? That was really good. Moo. I love pretending to be a cow.
This is a cow. Did you know that cows eat around 35 to 50 pounds of grass each day? A female cow is known as a cow, but a male cow is known as a bull. They're highly sociable animals. And best part about it is they provide us with milk. Thank you, cows. Bye.
I had such a fun time pretending to be a cow with you. Oh, did you hear that? Oh my goodness, that's a silly sound. I think the sound is coming from inside the farmhouse. Let's knock on the door three times. One, two, three, open. What is that? Oh my goodness, it's a horse. This is a beautiful horse. Hey, let's spell horse. H-O-R-S-E. Hey, let's make a horse sound together. Can you say neigh with me? One, two, three, neigh! That was so good. Now let's pretend we're horses, and these will be our hooves. Neigh, neigh, neigh! Oh, that's so fun.
This is a horse. Did you know that horses have bigger eyes than any other mammal that lives on the land? Horses can sleep both standing up and lying down. And they can run up to 27 miles per hour. They love hanging out together. They're a herd animal. And wow, did you see that horse jump over that? That was awesome. All right, take care, horse.
Wow, we've learned about a pig, we've learned about a cow, and we've learned about a horse. I wonder what's gonna... Oh, did you hear that funny sound? Oh, there it is again. Hey, I think the sound is coming from inside the farmhouse. Let's open the door. Open. Oh, what is that? Oh, it's a little duck. Hi, little duck. Ducks say quack, quack, quack. This is how you spell duck. D-U-C-K. Can you pretend to be a duck with me? You can put your hand like this and go quack, quack, quack. Can you try? Whoa, that was really good. Quack, 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 quack. I love pretending to be a duck with you. Quack, quack, quack.
This is a duck. Ducks eat grain, seeds, nuts, fruits, insects, water plants, and even small fish. Male ducks are called drakes and female ducks are called hens. And baby ducks are called ducklings. Ducks fly in a V shape. This shape makes them fly easier. And did you know that ducks can see underwater as well? Ducks are very sociable and they live in groups called rafts or teams. Hey, quick question. What's a favorite duck snack? Quackers! Quackers, get it?
Ducks are so cute and I love when I see them swimming in the water. Oh, what was that sound? I think it came from inside the house again. Let's open the door and see what's inside. Oh my goodness! It's a sheep! This is how you spell sheep. S-H-E-E-P. This is the sound a sheep makes. Bah, bah, bah. It's so fun. Can you make that sound? Hey, that was really good.
These are sheep. Did you know that sheep have very large curling horns made out of keratin? It's the same element that is present in human fingernails. And sheep can recognize up to 50 other sheep and remember them for 2 years. Sheep are herbivores, which means that their diet does not include meat. They typically eat seeds, grass, and plants. And their wool keeps them cool during the harsh hot days and keeps them warm during the cold days. Wow, that is a lot of sheep. Let me try to count. One sheep, two sheep. Oh, I'm so tired now and I don't know why. All right, bye sheep.
Wow, we've seen so many animals. I wonder what we're gonna see next. What was that sound? That was a really funny sound. I think it's coming from inside the farmhouse again. Let's open the door. Open. Oh my goodness. It's a goose. It's so cute. Hey, this is how you spell goose. G-O-O-S-E. And this is the sound a goose makes. It goes honk, honk. Can you say honk, honk with me? Honk, honk. Oh my goodness, that was so funny.
This is a goose. And when you get more of them together, they're known as geese. Geese eat seeds, nuts, grass, plants, and berries. They love blueberries. And geese can live almost anywhere. They like fields, parks, and grassy areas near the water. Some geese migrate every year, and others stay in the same place year round. Did you know that a male goose is called a gander? A baby is called a gosling? And a group of geese are called a gaggle? And a mother goose is called a mother goose? Hey, goat!
I'm having so much fun learning about animals with you. I think the next animal might be... Oh, did you hear that sound? Hey, let's open the door to see which animal is inside the farmhouse. Ready? Open. Oh my goodness. This is called a rooster. This is how you spell rooster. R-O-O-S-T-E-R. This is the sound a rooster makes. Cock-a-doodle-doo! Can you go cock-a-doodle-doo with me? One, two, three, cock-a-doodle-doo! That was really good. Let's pretend that we're roosters. Roosters go like this. And now let's say cock-a-doodle-doo. Cock-a-doodle-doo! Hey, that was really good.
Roosters are the male version of a chicken. Roosters are larger, usually more bright color, and have larger combs on the top of their heads compared to hens, which are female chickens. They're very protective. They can't smell good, but they have great sense of hearing. Cock-a-doodle-doo, Mr. Rooster.
Being a rooster was really fun. I love to flap our arms. Oh, whoa. Did you hear that sound? It was pretty loud. What animal do you think it could be? Ooh, maybe. Hey, let's open the door and see which animal is inside. Ready? Open. Oh my goodness. This is a dog. This is how you spell dog. D-O-G. And this is the sound a dog makes. Woof, woof, woof. Hey, let's pretend that we're dogs together. You could put your paws up like this. Woof, woof, woof. Aw, what a cute dog. Woof, woof, woof.
This is a dog, and it's the most popular pet on the planet. Did you know that a dog can learn over 100 words and gestures? This one is protecting the herd for its owner. That's a good dog. Dogs' noses are 40 times more sensitive than ours. I wonder what they're looking for. And did you know it's more exciting for them to put their head out the window and smell everything around? I wonder what this dog is doing. Are you sneaking up on some sheep?
Wow, I think we have just one more animal to learn about in the farmhouse. Hey, there's the sound. I wonder what animal it could be. Let's open the door. Knock, knock, knock. Open. Oh my goodness. This is a donkey. This is how you spell donkey. D-O-N-K-E-Y. And this is the sound a donkey makes. Hee-haw, hee-haw. So funny. Hey, let's pretend that we're donkeys together. Our hands will be our ears because donkeys have big ears. And we'll say, hee-haw, hee-haw, hee-haw. That was so fun.
This is a donkey, and it's a part of the horse family. Did you know that some donkeys can see all four of their feet at the same time? And donkeys have large ears to help them stay cool, but also so that they can hear their funny laughs of their friends 60 miles away.
I had so much fun learning about all of these farm animals with you. We learned about a pig, and a cow, and a sheep, and a horse, and a dog, and a duck, and a donkey, a goose, and a rooster. And you did such a good job making all the sounds that these animals make. I can't wait to see you next time. Bye! Hello, my stars! We are going to learn the words thank you. T-H-A-N-K-Y-O-U. Let's sound it out. Thank you! Thank you! How you sign thank you. Put your hand up to your chin and you go down. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Here is an example of thank you. Thank you for cleaning up your toys. Thank you for cleaning up your toys. You. You're so smart. Can you show me how to say thank you? Oh my goodness! You're so good at this. Thank you for joining me. Bye-bye. Hello, friends. The word is bye. Let's spell it. B-Y-E. Let's sound it out. B-I. Bye. 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 This is how you sign by. Put your hand up and you open and close it. Bye-bye. 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 Bye. 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 When I say goodbye to my friends, I wave bye-bye. Can you wave bye-bye? You're so good. Okay there. Bye.